really about the Sonic Moments of Antiquarian or very beautiful when they were playing. Here's a grand example of females that have been done in my preservation of this place. I mean, alas, in every case, the chimney and the engine room must have been demolished. It was like a mouse, didn't it? So a gold bird. When you think, there were possibly dozens of those things, and each time there was that old and much more bold thing back then, one almost winning on the other. Is roughly level with outside, you see. And if we'd have went as when the ground were up to level with where you are, if we'd have cut in here, it would have cracked 3 or 4 feet up. But when it goes over, if it tips back, it can shove the side of the mill in. The reason for digging it all is hopefully, and I say hopefully, it'll crack off down below ground and below the level of the floor inside the mill. Well, that's why we've done this big fence, you see. It's going to be a while wait on them pillars now, aren't they? The wire hawser is sort of an attempt to keep the base together in one piece till it gets, till it's found out which direction it's going to go in, sort of thing. And notice from previous experience that you get one with of all the iron bands on the bottom, it really helps to, you know, keep the thing together when it falls over. The important thing is to keep as much of it from falling backwards, you know, by having this wire all the way around. We've just done this sort of thing before, and it works, you know. It might look a bit sort of strange and a bit beauty when you think of the weight that you're dealing with, but it's not like weight. It's just keeping the thing contained, you know, sort of style. And as I say, if it's got to, like, nearly 45 degrees, and it's still got a grip of it, that wire rope, it's not going to do any harm anymore, you know. It'll come down without touching the mill.
Which is over the front of the wires, is to actually protect the wire from the fire.
It's a beautiful way, and it was quite a lot.
Yeah,
well,
I think so. Yeah. So, how do you find the usual amount of trouble with the ignition system?
I'm going to go with that one. It's going to be the
character. Yeah, I don't know. It's always the same, you know. We can never ever get the same score.
It's not easy to always know. It's not easy to always
know. It's not easy to always know. It's a good impression when you're on the time limit of the start to start. When you're trying to get the same note. Never more than the same
website.
It's the beginning of an unbelievable half an hour of sort of nervous tension. If you want to blow something up, can you press a button? Because then it's just a sword until you do it. So you press a button as it is. Before you. The rest is a bit different. Once you've got the fire going, it's entirely out of your hands. It's in the hands of the fire itself. You've got to get the fire going now, so it's right in the middle of the furnace. Which is quite important for the rest of the control of the fire. It's very important that one, which is always a good thing. Slightly frightening when you really feel how close the rest of the fire is in there. I'm assuming it's nice now. It always works. In the olden days, in the Victorian era, the chimney fire, you actually used to use coal for the fire. Normally, started after 1880s, but really it's the last 80, which means that the chimney is actually moving in the right direction. So there is a string that went on just to keep the function. And eventually, it's strange. It's sort of to be so close to such a weight that it's going to become very fast in a few seconds. This is like an unusual feeling. I don't think that I had a goal in the fire escape. So I could disappear in the sun and it's not why you could stood on the ground so close to the fruit chimney that I mean. You have no hands away 18 inches off the phone. And the feeling of confidence is all the way down to the floor and see the gap between in the fingers on the floor on the back and between the mill and the chimney stack. And then I wake up and see the thing going away. And my eyes travel down the full length of it. And I could see it weren't breaking it up, and it was going in a straight place. I can't see the straight in the sand, as it were. The thing I said, I just didn't have to run out of the way, I didn't have to go anywhere at all, it wasn't great. Beautiful. We know where we're going to get the body on the floor, so that's up 30 feet from the door, so you've no need to do that.
What do you think you're at, man? 4'6" in there.
Scratch
the window for me.
So there's no need to run from the life anyway. It's quite, that's a wonderful feeling.